Hello, everyone. Welcome to a very special edition of Stocks to Watch. We're actually joining you in Stockholm, Sweden, at the Nordic Funds and Mine Conference. And we have two very special guests from Sonoro Gold Corp. Sonoro Gold Corp is trading on the TSXV as SGO and the OTCQB as SMOFF. And it is my absolute pleasure to welcome both of you, Ken MacLeod and John Darch. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ashley. Yes. Pleasure to see you again.
Yes, it's so wonderful to see you in person. And we are here at this investor conference. Tell us how it's going so far.
Been going really well. High quality people that we've met here today, and we're quite impressed with this inaugural edition of the conference. It's getting off to a really good start.
Oh, that's wonderful to hear. Absolutely.
Very interesting people. Those who are really interested in what we're doing. And so it's good to have people who will come through and actually ask questions that are meaningful, and knowing that they're listening, and by the with their responses, they understand what we're doing.
And speaking of which, maybe you could give us a quick, brief overview of what it is you do at Sonoro Gold, where you are in the process right now, and anything you feel like it's important to discuss.
We are at a watershed hour here with the political situation in Mexico. We were operating Sonora State, which is by far the finest state in Mexico to develop a gold project. In fact, the majority of the gold produced in Mexico is mined in Sonora State. But the problem we've had over the past few years in Mexico is the government under President López Obrador was somewhat anti-mining. To the point where there was a proposal to ban open pit mining in the future. And of course that affected us, because we were expecting to get our environmental permit to build our mine almost 2 years ago. And if that had been the case, we'd have been in production for the past year and we'd be enjoying the fruits of a $2,600 gold market. So as it stands today, we're now looking forward to President-elect Sheinbaum to take over the reins of power and be sworn in on October the 1st. And we believe that President Sheinbaum will be a good example of a president that engages with the mining community and encourages mining in Mexico and encourages foreign investment into mining in Mexico. Because the third largest contributor to foreign direct investment is in the mining sector, would you believe? And even in the past year, the foreign direct investment into mining has been at record highs, because even though there's not a lot of new exploration taking place in Mexico, the current companies that are producing in Mexico are reinvesting their profits back into expansion of their mines and producing new mines based upon the extensions of existing mines. So we're looking forward to getting the new government entrenched and hopefully seeing the new government embrace the mining community and engage with us. And we believe that we as miners will be able to accommodate the needs of the political situation in Mexico, which requires the highest standards of environmental review and environmental adherence to the standards. So we believe that it's going to be a win-win situation for the government and, of course, the foreign mining companies and the Mexican mining companies, too.
And I know it's been difficult. As you said, you would be enjoying the fruits of the labor a year ago, and especially with gold at this price right now. But maybe timing is everything, right? And you just never know, especially when it comes to the government and maybe having somebody that is more interested in what it is you're trying to do and recognizes the importance of it is a win-win as well. So,
well, if I can finish off on that political situation, the government of Sonora State is very intent on getting the approval for not just our project, but other projects that are awaiting approval and have been for several years. And so 25% of the GDP of Sonora State is derived from the mining industry. So it would be a tremendous death blow to the economy of Sonora to have any kind of implementation of a mining ban on open pit mines. And it's not just Sonora. Zacatecas is even a larger percentage, 33% of the GDP. So, and I could list off six or seven other major mining states in Mexico as well that would be affected. So we believe very strongly that the collective will of these governments in states like Sonora will have an impact on the future development of the mining industry throughout the country as well. And so we have a lot of confidence right now that over the last quarter of this year, 2024, and getting into the first quarter of 2025, we will see solidification of the mining industry and the clarification of the rules going forward to the point where we should be able to thrive in Mexico.
Fantastic. John, would you like to add anything?
And we're well positioned to move forward, which is a good thing. There's a lot of confidence now, not just with us, but other mining companies, that there will be changes. And actually, you know how difficult it has been in the junior mining sector in these last few months. But Sonora has been relatively stable. We have a large shareholder base, you know, the insiders. We hold some 27, 28% of the shares. And we're very fortunate that over in Europe, they hold about 45% of the shares. All people who are looking and invested in the company go into production. And we will be announcing the closing of a fully subscribed private placement tomorrow. We announced it originally at $700,000, and we anticipate we're going to close it at about $875,000, oversubscribed. And what we're particularly pleased with is that three individuals will be participating to the extent of $600,000. Now, these individuals are sophisticated, one out of Germany, one out of Canada, and one from the United States. Now, that to us is a very strong indication that people recognize the potential. And with Sonoro, as you're aware, we're somewhat unique in the junior mining sector. We're unique insofar as, and of course, unique is thrown around so much, I want to explain that word. Look at the management and the insiders. We have four individuals, you can call them experienced, mature, old, whatever you choose. But we've all been in the business for some 40 years, and the four of us have got together for this one project.
Yes.
We're very commercial, we're business people, and the interesting thing about the individuals is that we're not all the same. We have a mining engineer, a geologist, financing, and marketing, but we've come together, and our belief and our commitment has resulted in us making a significant investment into the company, i.e. 28% of the shares. And what we've also done, which I think is a great credit to the company, is that during these months of difficulties in the marketplace,
yes,
we have put up shareholder loans of almost $4 million. No conversion rights, no special terms, etc. And we've done that as an alternative to doing a dilution. Nobody wants to have shareholder dilution. So we've put the money up, and we will either get repaid through project financing or when we go into production. Now, as to a legitimate question is, why did you have to put up the money? That's for property payments. And when we were planning to go to production, as it was in 2022, with the project lender, it was always contemplated that the property payments would be paid from the financing. When the mining license didn't come through and the project lender withdrew, we were able, fortunately, from the insiders, to fund it ourselves.
Yes.
Now, that's why I say unique. Not many junior mining companies have the insiders who are prepared to put up that much money and to follow their interest. And one thing we say to people, do not be concerned about rolling back the stock. That's not our intention. We have a lot of loyal shareholders who have been with us, and that's not what we're going to do. So in saying unique, I talk about the people. The project itself and all the mining projects I've been involved with, this must be by far the easiest. It's essentially earth moving.
Yes.
It's the cost of the earth, the cost of the extraction.
Right.
And with gold, when we did our first review, I think it was about $1,600 in Ken. But then we did the PEA, it was $1,800. And today we're $2,650. The economics are considerable, obviously. Now, we talk in terms of the net present value and the IRR. We can only relate that up to the price, say, $2,000 an ounce. But consider where it would be now at $2,650.
Yes.
So we have the people, we have the project. An important part is the business plan. Now, we've always been very much on a business plan. Our original business plan, from which we've never wavered, was we drill sufficient to go to production, and from the revenue, we will then expand the resource, and we will then look at underground, because we know that we have some very high-grade areas. In Guadalupe, El Colorado, some very high grades there. So our business plan was very clear, and we've never wavered from that. People wanted us to go and play roulette and go high grade, but no, we want to make sure that we'll be profitable. So the business plan. And then the last part, which makes us somewhat unique, we have a history of raising money. Yes. When other companies can't raise money, we've raised money. And go back through time, and Ken and myself, we've probably raised, say, $300 to $400 million for various projects. So as a junior company, we have a group of people who have been involved in the discovery, development, operations, and selling companies. So we are convinced that we will take this through to production. And again, unlike a lot of junior companies, we have the capability to do it. That's because the capital cost is so low. We have a low capital cost, open pit mining operation. Now this begs the question of, if you're going to take it through to production all by yourself, what's the exit strategy, say, for a shareholder? That will be for possibly mine goes to production, the dividends, or may well be we get taken over. Now, we've had other companies look at us, talk to us. There's always a lot of interest. And the higher the price of gold, with our costs pretty much fixed, the attractiveness gets more and more. So we're in a really good position. We're very happy. Happy to have that summer behind us of the difficult times. And we sense it from our shareholders, from the interviews we have, from the people there. They speak with enthusiasm. And that's something which we hadn't heard from for about a year.
So you have the people, the plan, as you said, the funding, and I would add the commitment to your shareholders. I would say absolutely. And speaking of whom and potential investors, might you have a pitch for them and why they should get involved and why they should pay close attention to Sonoro Gold right now?
If you take a situation of a share structure of a company, from an investor looking at it, is how much do the insiders have involved? What's their commitment? Very hard to argue when the insiders have 28% of the company, and our cost is about 13 to 14 cents a share. We're trading at 5 cents. Very hard to argue about the commitment when the insiders will put up almost $4 million in loans, unsecured. So why should somebody look to get involved in Sonora now? We have seen over the last year a trading of some 50 million shares from a high of 8 cents, large part of the year, then the decline during the summer months. But now we see it's coming back up and it's trading steadily here. And the trading level is starting to slow down, which means to say that the sellers have gone, most of them. So if there's going to be any pressure as we go now, it'll be an upward side pressure. So from the investor's point of view, and I can say this with honesty, I say it to my family as well, it's almost like buying an option, 5 cent option, for a company that could potentially have net present value of several hundred million dollars. I say potentially because we don't have independent verification. But look at what we have. We have only drilled 30% of the known mineralized area, right? So the potential for expansion is significant. So this to me is the beginning of the journey. It's a good entry price. Look at who's involved in the shares, what's their commitment, what's their tenacity, and are they likely to be successful?
Yes.
And having said that, assuming that we were to get the environmental permit approval today, we would be pouring the first doré bar within 12 months from now. It's that simple. We're not looking at a very, very long period of time to construct the mine, because there's no major construction involved. It's just a matter of getting the open pit ready for actual production, strengthening the roads to accommodate the larger trucks, locating the crusher, the leach pad, and the ADR plant to process, and then that is it. You know, so 12 months is a very conservative time to actually build the mine. We could do it in less. It has been done in a much, much lesser time by our team, but we're saying 12 months as an appropriate time for us.
Fantastic. Well, we will be following you very closely and very excited to see that first Dory bar filled.
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
So will I.
May I say
Wonderful.
Just one thing,
yes.
Please? The concern that people have over the mining license and how it's dragged on and dragged on and dragged on. The media, when it picked up the proposal to ban open pit mining, they dropped the word proposal. So effectively, in the investment world, it said open pit mining is banned.
Yes.
It was never banned. It's a proposal. And the outgoing president is now in the last few days of his presidency. And we're hopeful and we believe that we will not see this ban. But what shareholders should know is we're always looking to make sure we have the downside covered. So Ken and the team are busy looking at the underground potential. Because if it were a situation that the mining license is not granted for a while, it's not a matter of sitting around, what do we do? Ken and the team are working on how can we look and develop an underground operation, which was always in our business plan, but it was at the tail end. But if circumstances mean we have to bring it forward, that's what we would do.
Fantastic. Excellent point. Thank you for adding that. Both of you, thank you so much for joining us. John Darch, Ken MacLeod, thank you so much for joining us from Sonoro Gold. We look forward to following your journey and 12 months counting down.
Yeah. 12 months coming. Absolutely. Ashley, it's a pleasure seeing you again.
Okay. A great pleasure, especially in person.
Yes, especially in person.
It makes such a big difference.
Yes. Thank you
so much. Thank you.
Thank you.